Are you lost? You're not the first traveller, and you certainly won't be the last to get lost out here in the void. Space is a big place. Where are you from? Earth. I've met a few humans before. None quite as nice as you. Yes. Where were you traveling? Really? So far, so far. Well, don't worry. I'm going to help you get there. That's right. You're not actually here with me, you see. You're safe on your craft, traveling through the stars. It's peaceful and quiet around you. Yes. You're in a deep, deep sleep. Your technology isn't quite the same as some other races I've met. No. So you have to sleep as you travel across space until you reach the planet you're going to. Only the very lucky traveler gets to meet a space nymph when they're sleeping. That's right. You're very lucky. You haven't met one before. You might have met some of my sisters back on Earth. Ah, yes. You have the sight, that's why. Let me show you something. This is what you're traveling through. Stars, solar systems, across the galaxy. You're going so fast, but you don't feel it. You just feel the warmth and the relaxation of being with me. That's right. You passed your solar system long ago, all the way past Saturn, Jupiter, Mars, Mercury, and Pluto. You flew and flew and flew through space, all alone. But when you get to your destination, you'll be with friends and loved ones. Do you see the stars? So many. But it's so sad. Once we see the star, they've already gone. Poof. But it's nice to see them one last time. The stars out here give off light. That's right. Would you like to see some? There's all different kinds, different types of light. depending on the type of star, the lights have different properties. This is from a dying star, as you can see. It's not as bright as it could be. This is from a newborn star that was just created recently. It's a cool, cooling star and cold to the touch. Unlike the star near your planet, this one. Feel it from the light, the ice cold light. Yes, it's very much like the expanse of space, the light from the cool star. What about this last one? Shall we see? This one seems to be a lot like the sun near your earth, but not as strong. It's a warm light, yes. A warmth you can feel radiating off it. So can heat up even in the cold of space. Different properties, different feelings. That's right. What about these ones? These are from larger stars, crystals full of different properties from that star. has healing properties. Yes. It can heal even mortal wounds. You just need to keep it on your person. Just hold it, and it will cure any ailment, any disease, any pain. It will take it away completely. You said you met some of my sisters on Earth, then you'll know that we nymphs like to collect. I have many healing crystals in my collection, so you can take this one if you like. Keep it with you. Let the healing properties wash over you. They'll wash over I do have other crystals, of course. Travelers use them for all sorts of different things. This one is used to make fire. That's right. Travelers take it with them to make campfires, and some even use these to cook. Can you see the energy inside of it? Let it keep you. Use them together. If you want to brew a warm healing tea, simply use these crystals. That's right. So many different things you can do with them. I'll let you keep. This one is used for light, so you can use it to light your way through the darkness. It can be used to help you find your way back. That's right. You can simply point it to a map and it will show you where you need to go. Hold it, and it will act as a compass, and it will point the way. The way won't always be where you think it is, but the crystal knows where you should be. Or they could be simply decorative. They're very pretty, wouldn't you say? the magic shines through, even the darkest place. Can you feel the magic working? Can you feel it washing over? This one is quite rare. Yes, it's known as the Passion Crystal. And witches and warlocks and alien species use this to make love spells. It can be used in potions. Or it can be used physically by giving it to the one you love. Yes, it can be quite dangerous in the wrong hands. We don't just give these away to anybody. They must be earned, and you must know that you can trust whoever you give it on to. We nymphs like to hold on to these, but we very rarely give them to anyone. I'm not sure if I can trust you, so I think I'll keep this one. Final crystal. This one shines with a blue light. And this one is an energy crystal. Can be used to power spaceships, and if you know how, it can even be used to power a living thing. If you use it with the healing crystal, the energy crystal can become like a heart for anyone needing. Quite special. You can feel revived even from just being near it. So peaceful. So those are all my crystals. You can take these four with you. You mustn't share them with anyone. Once a nymph gives someone else that crystal, you have to keep it secret and use them only in dire circumstances. starlight is used in many ways. We sometimes like to keep it and bottle it so that all the different kinds of starlight, like these, can be kept together. Let me show you. Do you see all the different colours of starlight? They light up. All of the different properties are held in this wand. And they all do different things. Only a nymph can control all of these things. You must be very careful with whom you share your power. Would you like me to show you? Yes. This will help you find your inner peace and show you where you need to be. Can be used in all sorts of ways with more intense power. Do you see it? It's very strong, very powerful. Final things that I want to share with you are these tiny, tiny fragments of dead stars. Tiny. You can take these and keep them on you at all times because they're so small. They're from stars that will never burn again, so they're very special. Take them. They'll keep you safe. So continue your journey, fall back into a deep sleep, and travel through the stars until you get to your destination.